Well, hello there, boys and girls. Welcome back to another episode here on the channel of the Pokemon Platinum Wedlocke. Last time we made it to Florima Town, and that was it. We didn't do anything else. So let's go ahead and take a step into the Pokemon Center. And we're going to heal up our Pokemon and talk to some of the people around the town, see if there's anything interesting going on here. You know, it's been a few years, quite a few years, honestly, since I played this game. This was, I think this came out in 2007 or 2008, this game came out. And I have forgotten so much about it, but it still is just really enjoyable to go back and play. One thing that I remember not liking is I feel like a lot of the animations are slow compared to the third-gen games. The third-gen games, of course, like Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald, ran a little bit faster on a quicker engine than this game, but I still think this game is elegant and has one of my favorite graphic styles of any of the games. Welcome to Floroma, the town of flowers, flowers, and more flowers. You should plant some flowers of your own, too. Yay for flowers! Flowers are pretty fun. Here we go. We got some berries here, so we're going to pick these up. Berries in Nuzlocke are insanely useful, so I'm going to grab as many of these as I can. Oranberry is going to be restoring health, so something like a citrus berry is going to be great. So let's see here. We can buy some in here. We can trade. I think we get a watering can in here as well. Let's head over here and talk to her. Hello, would you like to exchange your berries for some accessories? Well, no, I'm not interested in accessories at all. A single berry will grow into a plant that makes several berries. By planting one, there will be more and more berries in the world, and hope you will help us spread more berries everywhere. So we get a free Chesto berry. That's a good one that stops sleeping. Trainer, please water using the spray duck watering can. All right, we get a spray duck. So this will allow us to plant more berries and get more berries in return, which is awesome. Sadly, I'm probably not going to be back here anytime soon, so I'm not going to really plant many berries right now. Seems kind of redundant. And let's see if there's... I'm going to do some item management real quick. Okay, so we sold some items there. Nobody there, I think, is really necessary to talk to, so let's go ahead and see who's in this house down here. Some kinds of Pokemon only appear if they're attracted by the sweet scent of honey. That is true, so honey is going to be a way that we're going to be able to get some encounters in these areas that typically don't have encounters, so that's exciting. This is Route 205, we're going to have another Chesto Berry here, and then I believe a Petcha Berry. And I probably will replant here because we're going to be staying in this area for a little bit of time. And I think I'm just going to go ahead and do an Oranberry and a Petcha Berry or something like that. So let's do one Petcha. And let's water it. And so I believe, if I'm correct, the watering mechanic in this game, you have to come back and water it like every stage of growth along the way in order to get the maximum amount of berries, which is kind of obnoxious, but that is okay. All right, we planted those. Look at this pretty field of flowers. Always like that. And I know there's a ton of hidden items around here as well, but I just can't remember exactly where they're at. I got drawn here by the sweet scent of honey. Seriously, what's that? What am I? A Pokemon or something? Hmm, honey. Do you know about Residia flowers? They're given as bouquets to express feelings of gratitude. It's an enduring tradition around these parts. And that is how you get one of the Pokemon Shaman later in the game. Do you think it's cute how Pokemon pluck berries? Here's a TM for pluck. So this, I believe, is a flying type move that a lot of Pokemon can learn, and it's decently strong as well. So that is nice. So one day this was a barren town, and then a Pokemon came and gifted the gift of flowers, and they grew everywhere. That's really cool. Aren't we Team Galactic? And we're assigned here? Standing around among flowers? This doesn't seem all that cool. Hey now, don't complain. This is a pretty decent assignment. Bug and grass type Pokemon so creep me out. I don't like being here either. Well, yeah, you guys are not in the area for that. Bug and grass types love Floroma Town, so not the place to be. Alright, we've explored everything there. Let's head over here to Route 205. There's a little girl.
Help, help, trainer, please. I want to see my papa. My papa and I live in the Valley Windworks, but then a whole bunch of people dressed like spacemen came, and they kicked me out, and they're making my papa do something. Please, trainer, I miss my papa.
Well, that does not sound great. We're going to head over here, and we're going to get a new encounter for the Valley Windworks. We could save it for a honey encounter, or we could save for a drift balloon encounter. That appears on Friday. They appear every Friday here, and today is not Friday. But what I'm going to do is just go ahead and get a standard encounter here. Let's lead off with Green Tea, because Green Tea is going to be able to use a move like Stun Spore, which is going to make catching a Pokemon a lot easier. It's also the highest level Pokemon we got right now. And our encounter is a Buizel, which is pretty cool. Water type. And a really, really cool design Pokemon. Alright, let's go ahead and use Stun Spore. It knows Quick Attack. And it's going to poison itself, which is going to make not only catching it a little bit tougher, because now we're on a time limit, but the Stun Spore does nothing. But it still doubles the chance of catch, so let's just go ahead and use a Pokeball and see if we can't catch this. Oh man, it's going to be difficult. That's okay, we got a little bit more time. It's going to use Water Gun. We should resist that as a grass type, so that's not going to do too much. Alright, let's just try a regular Pokeball again. As we get closer, I might use the Great Ball. I do want a Buizel. And we got it. So this thing is orange. Buizel is orange. It really reminds me of Orange Crush. So I think we're going to name it just Crush. Orange Juice wouldn't be bad either. How about we just do OJ for Orange Juice, all right? Not OJ Simpson. Not any other famous OJs. OJ for Orange Juice, all right? All right, let's go ahead and continue on here. Don't you dare go into the Valley Windworks. I got my orders to keep everyone out if they're not part of Team Galactic. You're giving me a look that makes me think you're going to try to get in. Okay, then. You'll have to battle me for it. Hopefully this battle isn't too tough. I am leading with Badoo and or Green Tea and Bean, and both of them are honestly not that strong. They're probably my weakest duo, even though their levels are one of the highest. So we get a fake out here. It's always going to go first, and it's always going to flinch. Scratch. Oh, we're getting kind of low. We're down to 12 HP. I might have to heal. I really don't want to have to swap. Alright, we got some HP back, so unless we get crit, we're fine. Oh, Hypnosis. This is no good. Don't like this at all. Alright, so we are asleep now, which means I'm going to swap to Bean. And Bean is going to take a lot of damage, I think, from like a scratch or something like that, so I am very hesitant. Okay, that didn't do too bad. Let's try to go for Fury Cutter. I think I want to go for Fury Cutter here and just stack it. The more you use Fury Cutter in a row, the more damage it does. So, you know, the second or third time, it should be doing enough damage to... Oh my goodness. Okay, this is bad. Well, worst case scenario, Bean gets really low and we swap out. It's going to just keep using Growl, which is lowering our attack, but we're getting off Fury Cutters, which are stacking up in damage, so it's not that bad. And we can drop the effects by switching out. It's going to use Scratch. You know, if Bean dies this turn, I will be a little sad, but I will be a little glad that we don't have to use Bean anymore. Oh. Why do I do this to myself? Wow. I honestly did not think I was going to get crit there. Obviously, I knew I was dead if I got a crit, but the chances were not that high, so I'm genuinely surprised. Let's just go ahead and use a Mega Drain here. I should be able to wake up this turn or next turn and get that off. And if I don't, then we just heal next turn. And we are good to go. So every battle in this game is actually so dangerous. You know, unlike some other games or when you're playing normally, it's not that challenging. This is actually a little challenging. I knew that was risky, but There we go. Yeah, like, I'm really supposed to win with this Pokemon? Isn't that just great? Getting owned by some kid. But you can't do a thing if I lock myself in with the works key. That's right, the other works key is not here. My cohorts in the field patch have the other one. Haha. In that sense, I'm no longer the loser. Nope, you're still a loser. So he locked it from the inside. Well, this means a few things. You know, Bean is going to be able to go and sleep with its first true love, Mountain Dew. And we're going to be able to get a new partner, maybe even a stronger partner for Green Tea. So even though this isn't the way I wanted it to go, this is the way it was meant to be. Bean wasn't the strongest anyway, so now we have a new chance. Green Tea and OJ can do this. And it's time to say goodbye. So with that out of the way, our new hot pair here of Green Tea and OJ. And I think OJ is physical, so that's not the best, but it does have some decent moves, and it's going to get access to moves like Surf and stuff anyway, so it's not going to be too bad. And we still have, of course, we still have Milk in the PC. But OJ being the only male available to pair, that was our option there, so that's where we're going to go with. Well, before we head up and find the other Galactic Grunts, I'm going to do a little bit of training. And we're going to head up and try to find that works key so we can head into the Valley Windmill here before too long. So I'm going to do some training. I think the level cap is level 22. Let me try to get everyone up to level around 18. And we will pick up from there. So be right back. Alright, over an hour later and we're back. Here is the result of my training. You see, I got Caffeine and Latte up to level 18. We're going to be using them up into the gym, and the level cap is level 22, so I didn't want to overlevel them. And then Green Tea and OJ, I leveled up a little bit, but we're going to get to some areas where it's going to be easier to level up these OJ later. And same way with Boba and Lemonade, we're really not going to be using them much until we get through the next area, in which we're going to be able to speed through that area. And then use it for training later on. So, take that into consideration. Let's go in here into the meadows and see what's going on.
Enough arguing. Hand over the sweet honey. Do as we say. Team Galactic will have that honey. We must have it to attract Pokemon in great numbers. Hey, this kid is a witness. What will do?
We don't need the brat running off to get help. The solution's simple. We ensure the brat stays quiet.
All right, so we got a battle here. I think this is a double battle. It is two single battles, scratch that. So this is a Stunky, and I believe the Stunky and Glammeow, same combo as last time, and it shouldn't be any problem this time either. So let's go ahead, and I think I'm just going to go with Ember because it is at least neutral. Fury Swipes. Oh, I still have the attack animations off. It does make training remarkably faster to have this, you know, the animations off, so I just need to remember to turn those back on so you guys can see that. Yep, no problem there.
This is why I'm going to be stuck as a grunt forever. This is so lame. They're going to dock my pay. I'm up next, battling you right after my cord weakens you gives me the edge.
Well, he didn't really do that much. He did Fury Swipe me 5 times, but it wasn't that bad. So he has a Zubat. Same thing here. This Zubat shouldn't be able to hit us very hard. Supersonic is going to be the worst thing it can use, and that just is going to confuse. Leech Life is going to do nothing. We double resist it. And then another Ember is going to take that out. Two Zubats. A pair of Zubats. You hate to see it. Zubat is probably one of the most annoying Pokemon, and we got a crit there. Just because they were so common in the first few generations, especially, you know, you walk into a cave, you're just going to get bombarded by Zubats. This brat's tough, like, really, really tough. Tougher than I can put into words, and I know a lot of words. We're done for here, let's get back to the Valley Windworks. Oh, what's this thing? They seem to have forgotten it. It's a works key, it must be for the Valley Windworks. It's no use to me, you must as well have it. Yeah, just this random key on the ground. You child, take this key. So they were trying to steal his honey. So he's going to give us some since we saved him. Slather that honey on a sweet-smelling tree and might attract a Pokemon. So that's actually what we're going to do. It's the only way to get an encounter in this route. So we're actually going to slather some honey here. And I believe that house right there belongs to this guy. You can actually get Munchlax and Heracross this way. Very, very rare chance to get both of those, but Snorlax and Heracross are definitely both in my top 10 favorite Pokemon list. So that is something to, I would love to get either one of those. They're just so much fun to use. Okay, battle scenes on. We'll do that. And we're going to heal up real quick, and then let's head back to the Valley Windworks. Alright, we've got the second key, and we should be getting Flame Wheel on Inferno soon. It's a great physical attack move. It's locked from the inside. Use the works key, ker-chunk, the door to the Valley Windworks open. Alright, we are good to go. Let's go in here. There's a grunt right off the bat.
What? No way, you have the key? Locking the door was meaningless. I'm the loser in this after all. This is no time for self-pity. I've got to alert the commander.
I love that they didn't really give them running animations, so they just kind of scurry really quickly. It's really great. Let's battle this guy here.
Oi, this is no fun and games. This is proper work, I tell ya.
I don't know why I gave him such an accent, but maybe I should do that more often. This is good work on my accents for when I have to entertain someone at a party or something. Okay, let's just keep using Ember. I think it's just going to be the most effective thing. Zubat cannot hit me at all. I don't think it has Wing Attack at this point, and that's the only move that could possibly do damage to me. Zubat's fairly weak, so yeah, 1 damage. So Ember is going to do fine. And once we get Flame Wheel, it's going to start one-shotting a lot of this stuff, so that's going to be awesome. It's level 19. And there is Flame Wheel. Can't learn more than 4 moves. Let's see which move we want to get rid of. I think I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of Scratch. I cannot think of a scenario in which I would choose Scratch over something else, so we're just going to go with Flame Wheel here. Taunt. I don't think it's going to be super useful, but we're just going to hold on to it in case there's a really specific scenario. This guy is optional, and I don't need to battle him, so I'm going to skip that guy. And here is the leader. I'm one of Team Galactic's 3 commanders. No, wait, that's 1 of 4 commanders. My name is Mars. We've been trying to create a new world that's better than this one, but people have shown little understanding about what we do. You don't understand either, do you? It's a little saddening. So, let's have a battle to decide what we should do next. If I win, you leave. If you win, we, Team Galactic, will leave. Alright, we have to win. We have to save the Windworks. We have to save the electricity that they're stealing from this place. We are challenged by Commander Mars. She has a 15-level Zubat. It's kind of a higher level, but it's still just a Zubat, so it shouldn't be a problem at all. Let's go with Flame Wheel here. We're stirring the caffeine up. Almost one shots. Oh, we do get a burn, which means that its physical attack is halved. We resist bite. It is going to do nothing. And we actually get a free turn here to do whatever you want. Let's just go ahead and take it out with Mach Punch. That's a priority move. And let's see what her next Pokemon is going to be. It is a Perugly. It is an evolved Super Ugly, and it is quite ugly here. So we have some options. It's probably going to use Fake Out is my guess. That's usually what they kind of do. Let's go with Mach Punch. Oh, they're going to use Fake Out. So that is the one of the higher priority moves. We can't do anything about that. We did flinch. Let's go with Mach Punch. It's going to be super effective on this normal type Pokemon. It does a lot, and it has some sort of berry, it seems. So it has an Oran Berry, but we should be able to take it out in the next attack. It's going to use Scratch, and let's use Mach Punch one more time. And we took it out. No problem at all. Caffeine is a beast. And we got kind of lucky with the type advantaging there. We're already level 20, so we really got to watch that level limit.
This can't be. I lost? You and your uppity brat? Oops, I messed that one up. That's alright though. I quite enjoyed our battle.
Charon, my, lose to a child, will you? But no matter, we've collected plenty of electricity. With the power we obtained, we can do something quite spectacular. It seems quite obvious to me, Charon. The genius, even the boss recognizes. Now, Maz, we should be going.
Will you shut it? The boss is the only person in the world who's allowed to order me around.
You can keep quiet around me. You only joined us recently. Don't think you're important. I guess it's time to say goodbye, and leave you for the time being.
Team Galactic. They were saying they had to gather Pokemon and energy no matter what. It was for creating a new universe, or so they claimed. Nothing they said made any sort of sense to me. I can't tell you how grateful I am for you to saving me, and I can finally see my little daughter again.
Papa! Yuck, Papa, you're stinky. Go shower now, stinky.
Oh, sorry. They had me working nonstop. Thank you, trainer. You made those bad people go away. I think the balloon Pokemon will come and visit again.
Yeah, so she's talking about Drifloon. It'll come and visit on Fridays in the Valley Windworks. So that is pretty cool. Not a Friday right now, so don't have to worry about it right now. But in a few days, we might come back and take a gander. Ah, yes, it is you. Yes. I heard that Team Galactic appeared at this power plant. I have, therefore, come running. So the Team Galactic, what are they? You have them running off, you say? You are a trainer, but... Very well. I shall go investigate inside. Okay, they're not letting me move here. He's going to come back, I'm guessing. Okay, good. Magnificent. Yes, it is. What you said, it is all true. Superb. Though you are young, you are a trainer through and through. Very well. I should pursue the culprits. I've received tips that Team Galactic hideout is in Eterna City. To there, I must be off. Yes, they do have a hideout in Eterna City, and that's where we're going to be heading in the next episode. Thank you guys so much for watching this Pokemon Platinum Wedlocke. This episode is a little bit longer. Hope that wasn't a problem for you guys. Thanks for sticking around to the end, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode.